keep on sinking down.
Okay.
Muscle memory or right. Something.
So another take?
I'll take yeah. But like on it, can we do a second track next to it? And that way, if it sucks, you just...
Yeah, like, do you want to... You're not saying hear both. You're just saying keep the other one.
Yeah, keep the other one. Yeah.
Thank you. there gives us a glimpse of a rising star, one in Chicago's very own.
With art, I don't think there's ever making it. It's just kind of seeing how long you can pay your bills making the music.
The 34-year-old indie singer-songwriter has been composing and singing since he was 16. He makes ends meet by playing in two bands, Submarine and Super 8-Bit Drummer.
What the hell?
Choosing not to get a day job so he could devote all of his time to writing and producing his music. For him, it's all about the music and the people who hear it.
When you're an artist making a living at art, you're less times chosen to do things and more times you just got to get the opportunities that come your way.
I like that they use the diamond one.
Boy, did an opportunity come his way. A childhood friend who worked at Atlantic Records got wind that the producers of Eclipse, the sequel to Twilight, were looking for a song for the movie's credits. Well, that friend gave Rob a call, and the two of them composed a little tune called What Part of Forever.
About 100 people got asked to write the song. They gave a shot, because it ends, they wrote it.
What Part of Forever is the song that plays during the ending credits.
Definitely an idol of mine. I think he's got one of the greatest singing voices in America and maybe all over the world. It was awesome writing for him.
It took Kleiner 2 afternoons, just 8 hours to score the credit.
Sometimes we slave over something for a month and sometimes it just comes together like that. And this is one of those lucky times where it came together really quick.
And I know all the things when I'm dreaming. Kevin Gibson is in both Tubring and Super 8-Bit Brothers with Rob. He's known and worked with him for years.
He's always working on music, and I mean, springtime he has. I mean, he's working on new music, and even if we're not doing it with, like, either of our bands, I know he's continually writing for something, so it's kind of just been a matter of time since something pays off.
And this is where the magic happens. In Rob's small studio in his Park Ridge apartment, Jovia Faye has been a fan of Rob's for years.
I would definitely call him gifted. He's got a lot of talent.
She sees big things in his future.
I think in like 2006, I told him he'd be the next Danny Elfman for sure. And he said, I'm doing a soundtrack. And I pretty much was like, well, I told you so.
I like to put cool stuff out in the world. I like to put art. I like to listen to music. I like to make music. It's just about making the music, you know.
Rob Kleiner, making music for the sake of art. He's one of Chicago's very
You were frozen.
It seems strange, but there's a dog with a Twitter account.
That was good. I like that.
A familiar face comes back to Wrigley in an unfamiliar uniform.
Going on over here.